So I realized something. My middle schooler has officially become smitten with a young lady at his school. And he asked me if it was okay to get her phone number so that they could text. And I thought about that for a second and I was like, oh my gosh. Like, they'll be able to talk to each other and I won't know that they're talking to each other. Because when I was in middle school or high school, when a boy asked for your number, they were calling the home phone. So mom or dad answered the phone, hello, who do you want to talk to? Meredith? Who is this? Is this a boy? Meredith, there's a boy on the phone. Oh my God, mom, stop. There's a boy on the phone. He wants to talk to you. Who are you? And then this utter awkwardness ensues. As soon as you get on the phone, you know they go into another room. They got on another phone and listened in and you heard them. Mom, I hear you breathing on the phone. Mom, hang up. Mom, I hear you on the phone. Hang up. And you do that forever, because that's how you communicated when you were in middle or high school with somebody of the opposite sex who was trying to call you. There was one number to reach you. There was one home phone. One way. If that phone rang at midnight, you know you were getting screamed at because somebody is trying to call you when everybody in the house is asleep. So now I'm starting to think about this and I'm like, oh my gosh. They could, you know, be communicating whenever. Like, I'm going to have to set some rules and some boundaries. And my brain started to go into overload and all of these things were happening because I realized nothing is like it was, you know, 25 years ago. I think it was also painful because I realized that I'm approaching 40 and I now have a child who wants to date. And I'm afraid and I'm scared. I'm having a range of emotions. I'm sweating a lot. He wanted to get her a Christmas gift, some chocolates and a stuffed animal. But as I'm wrapping this gift, I'm thinking to myself, you know, I loved him first. I took care of him. He's going to just abandon me for some girl. He's going to go off and he's going to just love her. He's going to love her and I'm going to be forgotten. And I'm thinking to myself, oh my gosh, oh my gosh. This is how a crazy mother-in-law is born. Wrapping chocolates for some chick who their baby boy has the hots for. This is how it happens. And I went down this awful rabbit hole and caught myself as I began to cry in the closet. But everything has changed. Everything is so different now. And now I just feel like I gotta watch him like a hawk. Like, he was playing with Legos last week, and now he wants a girl's phone number. For the love. For the love.